when there was already a stream there.
Yeah.
That was made. Do you know what I'm saying? That was made.
So the thing is,
like, if you bring a Diddy and stuff and even those, and what all these... So what all these guys have done, like, Diddy was like a pioneer, bro. He went to Sony and he said, I will work for free.
Yeah.
I will clean the floors. I will do whatever. I just love music. I want to get in there. That was his work ethic to get there.
Yeah.
But he grasped the concept of black people making it mainstream, having their own business, having their own labels, all that kind of stuff. And he wasn't the first, bro, because it goes back to even disco and blues and stuff. There were African American people looking, pressing their own vinyl and all that kind of stuff, like before Diddy and them around. But like that kind of thing made it possible for Jay-Z,
yeah,
for all these other guys to have the same ambitions,
yeah,
as him. Because what the labels were doing, bro, if you think about, I'm not even talking about, I mean, we can label it white old money. They're like, oh, these oaks are becoming successful. All right, so let's get our own. So what did they start doing? They started partnering with up and coming guys. So even though African guys were opening up their own record labels, it was in partnership
with
the old establishment.
Mm.
Do you know what I'm saying? So it's still like white people are like, well, powerful. Let's go, powerful people with money are like, oh, that's working. I hate that music, but that I just sold a million.
Yeah.
Hey, can make more. Where's your, hey, you're a black guy.
Yeah.
Wait,
yeah.
Don't you have connections that sing and do that funny
yeah, like bring me
rap,
tabak,
like swing stuff? Organize them. Let's put them in the studio. Let's see, you know?
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So like now it's a reality that like, bro, you can, a black person can start a label, a black person can be successful in hip hop, a black person can do all of this. So to determine like What has Drake done is like a controversial question, because we will always have different points of view.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? But the reality is like, if there was no stream there, what would Drake be doing if there was no such thing as hip hop?
So now this is a cable. Welcome everyone. Zeros and Black Spider-Man, Linda, you've joined us mid-conversation. The question being, what has Drake done for music? So this is where I'll jump in. This is Adrian, everyone. This is Jabs. Tobang is here. We got a boy Luke here. Josh is in the building. So my whole thing is, I agree with you that you can't necessarily change anything if there wasn't anything, if there wasn't like a lane already.
Yeah.
And I'm not discrediting what Diddy's done,
yeah,
but that wasn't the question. The question was, what has Drake done for music? Now I've said, and I don't, now this has become a hip hop thing. I'm not talking about hip hop. I'm talking about music. The past 10 years, the only thing that was popular was white girl pop music, Taylor Swift,
yeah,
One Direction bands. The past 3-4 years, it's been hip hop. It hasn't been, hip hop is pop music.
Because of Drake.
What do you mean it's not because of Drake?
It's not because
I'm not
of
saying
Drake.
It's, Drake is, bro. Who's more popular than Drake?
So what was
Jay-Z's like
involvement in this?
Jay-Z's been like, I'm the biggest Jay-Z fan ever. I love Jay-Z. Jay-Z is like my number one artist.
Yeah.
But I can even say, in the past 10 years, he's had number one albums, right?
Yeah.
But he's never been so universally loved by everyone, where people are like, that's the guy. Jay-Z is the greatest artist of all time, well, in the past like 20 years, for me at least.
Yeah.
I can say that because if you want to bring
so
sales,
do you think it's a timing
music
thing?
I think,
because
so,
think about Jay-Z, like when he got out of the game and started relaxing,
mm-hmm,
internet and social media exploded to new proportions that there never was.
Yes.
So people in deep dark South America,
mm-hmm,
started having access, or it was more in their faces than previous. Ever before.
Yeah.
Yeah. So like, it's what we say. It's like when we spoke about if Beyonce is like popular or whatever.
Mm.
Of course she's popular. She is. She's an institution. That's what Beyonce is.
She's got more than 10,000 followers.
She's an institution.
Yeah, she's millions.
Doesn't matter if we're. This is obviously, music is subjective. You don't have to be a fan to acknowledge someone's impact.
Yeah.
And I'm not talking about Drake's music now. I'm talking
about music. The whole
game. No, I'm talking about his impact.
Yeah.
So you're asking me what he's done
for the music.
For the music industry. I'm talking about music in general.
This is where you missed my question.
Yes.
What is the question?
What has Drake done musically?
So I said,
not the music industry.
So I said,
musically,
Drake hasn't done anything that hasn't been done before.
Yeah,
like people were singing before Drake, people were rapping before Drake.
Yeah, we get.
But people were being emotional before Drake. I'm not saying that, but he made that whole. Now maybe not him solely, but he was one of the biggest voices in that to make
Trey
this whole.
Was the biggest,
there was Trey Songz also, but Trey Songz wasn't rapping. I mean, like, but like that whole like emotional sad boy vibe.
Yeah.
Like Trey Songz is in there. You can bring him in. August Alsina, all these guys. But then you can Chris Brown, of course, man. Chris Brown and Drake.
Let's get it. I'm saying Chris Brown is popular than Drake.
More popular.
Ooh, yeah.
Calm down.
Okay, well.
And Drake is as far as old.
Okay, Chris Brown beats up women.
But
he abuses women. Whatever.
I'm actually a Chris Brown fan, so I'm just, I do like Chris Brown.
That the hairstyle
vibes
flop.
The reason why I brought up Diddy.
So we're not speaking of each other. Because if we hear now, Thank you, Director Josh. Appreciate you, bro.
The reason why I brought up Diddy, you said Drake made hip hop popular.
I said he made it mainstream. That's what I said.
Yes.
Nah,
but
yeah,
Diddy did have soft tracks.
Yes, he did.
He was a rapper.
Okay.
He had those tracks that didn't seem hard.
Back to my counter.
Yeah,
who's more popular now, Drake or Diddy?
But listen,
I'm not saying, but then once again, if people are listening, I'm not saying Diddy is any less or any better than Drake musically. That's not what I'm saying.
You're missing my point.
He's got guap more than Drake.
It doesn't mean anything. I'm talking about straight up popularity, bro. Drake and Migos are pop culture right now.
Yeah.
Are pop culture.
Yeah.
You agreeing with me?
Yeah.
So then why are we arguing?
Ghana.
Everyone is below Migos.
Everyone is below Migos. I'm saying they're about to change the game.
Okay, fine. They'll be next. But I'm talking about now. We're talking about now.
Migos and whoever this Drake, they're doing whatever they're doing.
You guys are agreeing with me.
But what I'm saying is that this guy hasn't done jack for the industry or whatever his question is. He's just like everybody else. He's just that he's
okay. Popping. So my counter question: do you have to change music in order to have impact? Because then I can easily.
He doesn't have impact. He people like his stuff. They don't wear what he wears.
You just
they
agree with me that Drake is as popular as me.
Anyway,
is the most popular.
He is popular, but then I look at him. I like the way he shaves his beard, his hair. I'm like, okay, that thing looks dope. Let me go try it on. I'm not doing it because
Bro,
I like
Drake
or what.
I don't like him.
Okay. I saw the hair with him because it's all over TV.
Okay, it's fine.
There we go. Then that's his impact.
Okay.
That's his impact.
Okay.
Whatever,
you
bro.
Agree
I'm
me.
Done.
Tabang agrees with me, guys.
I do not agree.
Fine. You say Drake made hip hop popular.
Mainstream. Yes.
That's wrong. That's wrong.
But
who's
set the path for Drake?
YMCMB.
As I'm saying,
young
like, no. I'm not talking about the.
Who said that? Okay, yes.
As who made, like, what Drake is doing?
Lil Wayne.
Who made it? Like a thing, like who made it? Like Drake can actually do what he's doing.
So
that's why I brought up Diddy.
Yes,
Diddy set the path, opened the door for hip hop artists to make hip hop so mainstream that no matter what you like,
yes,
hip hop
just maintained
will be a thing.
Maintained.
Okay,
and then I went back to Adriano's point earlier on when you brought up YouTube, like iTunes, what all of that.
I hate Drake.
Drake so happens to be in the time where it blew up. I'm just saying no, because you keep saying who's more popular between Diddy and Drake, but I'm just getting to the nitty gritty now. Like Drake, like we can't compare them because the times Drake is like his music career is like going up, and Diddy's time two different times. Drake has more resources where he can stay where he is. And just push it normally. He doesn't have to go.
That's a skill in itself.
Bigger
that's
and
a,
better
that's
to
a,
like
that's
push
a,
something.
That's a skill in itself.
Drake is old. So is it a skill or is it just?
They write for him. It's a ghost write.
In my opinion,
is it a skill or is it?
Oh my
is it privilege?
But he is a ghost writer.
Is it a skill or is it privilege?
It's Drake White.
I'd say it's privilege.
No,
it's Drake White.
It's color.
No, it's got nothing to do with color.
I say privilege.
It's about privilege
what he has.
In terms of timing, situation.
Is it just fault he was born the year he was born?
No. Like Linda.
So
yeah,
no.
What are you saying, bro?
Then it's like
you might as well agree with what I said.
Bro, then what are you saying?
I didn't disagree with you.
That's like a terrible like justification, bro.
What do you mean?
So all the white people that were born during apartheid, like, it was just bad timing. Or yes. Was it right timing?
Like, without parents, it was bad
timing. No, no, like, no. Come on, bro.
It's my fault.
It's my fault. Is it skill or privilege?
I think it's
time. Put Drake and Diddy's time. Tell me if it will be this.
Oh, man.
That's all I'm
that's
saying.
Like, okay. No, put Messi and Maradona. Put Messi and Maradona's time. Who's better?
No,
don't give me what ifs like that. Give me what ifs like that.
Look at
before you. Yes, I'm looking at you. I'm looking at jobs.
Put Drake and Diddy's time.
This is a stupid question. No, it's a stupid question.
He wasn't going to be popular because he was talking about love had broken.
Because it's a stupid what if. It's not going to happen. So why are you asking me?
I'm saying
it's not going to happen.
No, this is where skill comes in. Your marketing, all of that comes in.
Yes.
Diddy did not have SoundCloud, iTunes,
yes.
Spotify,
Go.
YouTube,
yes.
Blah, 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 so
yes.
on and so forth.
Yes, yes.
Drake does.
Yes.
Which makes it more easier for Drake to reach people.
To market.
The social media making Drake look cool. Making Drake...
How many...
So guys, just a reality. Like, you guys don't... You don't understand, okay? Any hip-hop artist who went platinum... Who went gold in the 90s, okay? You can't compare them with today because literally,
what you're doing.
There was guys, we only got MTV in this country in 95, 96. Okay, so for a South African to listen to Tupac, to Biggie, to any of those, dude, was like, dude, you could not hear it on the radio. It was banned. Even white people's music with lyrics was banned, bro, because it was like maybe it was talking about unity or living together in peace or whatever. But music was banned, bro. So like if you almost had like a privileged couple of people going to UK or America and then they heard hip hop or they heard like underground whatever music. And then they brought it into the country, and then you got like these people trying to record from cassette to vinyl, from vinyl or CD. Like, bro, it's like you don't understand. Access to music back then was a physical transaction that you were privileged to have access to. So, any artist who sold a million albums that was black in the 90s, dude. In my opinion, my personal opinion, that is equivalent to a billion album sales right now, because of access to like that's my personal thing. I'm you know, because the effort, bro. Those artists had to play and from town to town or pub to pub or club to club to just get recognized.
Yeah.
Bro, I don't have to do any of that today, bro. I can flip and we can record this. You can record me doing a twerking and me doing whatever right now, and I post it. All right.
All it needs
okay?
is one repost.
I haven't done anything, bro. I haven't edited it. I post it right now, bro, and people will comment. I have people's information. For those artists back in the day to even get their music, besides their family and their friends and the context they had. Physically, so I can't just say, "Do you want to listen to this on my phone?" I'm like, "No, bro. I need to get a CD. I need to actually take the music that I spent that hour doing, physically put it onto a CD." Even that process wasn't straight cut and clean, like right now. So you'd have to go and find CDs. You'd have to ask a buddy if he's got a CD writer on his machine. Okay, so that whole process is totally taken for granted because it's just become a way of life. So I'm not saying that it's bad. I'm just saying that when you look back, if you're looking at all of that, in my personal opinion, any person who went platinum, any black artist who went platinum in the 90s, God, like, bro, it is flipping phenomenal. Do you know what I'm saying? Compared, like, dude, imagine Michael Jackson and Tupac and Biggie and like I'm not even doing any of them justice, bro. We're in our day and age, and they just flipping in the studio record, and then they just like send something out onto the internet, dude. Like, yeah, I don't even. I'm not saying like, and the thing is, it's hard to say that because their music is not relevant now.
Yeah.
But if it wasn't for them making those parts, and doing something that people had never done before or heard before, but like we don't even understand the obstacles. Do you know what I'm saying? And like Tupac died when he was 24, 25, yeah, around there. Mm-hmm. And like you think about it, I think I could be mistaken, but in terms of all his record sales by his death, were like 13 million physical albums sold. Yeah. Bro, that is, to me, I mean, I could be totally wrong. 13 million, but 13 million albums by the time I was 25, physically sold, pre-internet, dude, is like, flip, we don't even understand that. Yeah. And there's some artists who don't even get 13 million views in this day and age, and people celebrate them and whatever, and a view is not me physically paying hard-earned cash. So there was no such thing as, well, there were singles, but like, bro, if I in 90 whatever, if I wanted to buy an album, I literally had to fork out between 80 and 200 rand in 1996 1995. Bro, who's playing 200 rand for an album these days? You can pay what, 9 rand for a song? You can stream it for free. Yo, bro, now to equate a free listener to someone who says, like, I like this guy, I'm willing to pay hard-earned cash for this album, bro. I could be wrong, maybe I'm mad in the head, but like, bro, that is just, it blows any artist today, like what those guys did and they spearhead and pioneered in, like, bro, America was free racially for like 30-40 years, but still there was racism, like you don't understand. So for any black artist in the 90s to be selling platinum, million albums, bro, to me are like trailblazers and like flipping superheroes in their own right.
Yeah.
And we underestimate what they achieved.
Like, with that, I'm not saying that Drake, him being born this time, was his choice. Obviously it's not, but like what exactly what Adriana said, I'm saying all the hard work, all the day-to-day hustling to just make a million sales, yeah, my, as our Adriana says, outpowers whatever artists do now. Artists right now can sell 20 million, but it's over the phone. Blue.
Okay, what argument are we talking about
now? I'm just taking it back to Drake.
What are you guys talking about
now? I'm just taking it back because he said to Drake, to Tabani, that he's on every white girl's phone.
Yes.
Stuff like
okay,
that.
Okay, so to his thing, to those artists who don't even have like a million views, they have the exact same resources Drake has. The exact same resources.
Drake just
dropped down, that's fine.
Bro, I have, even if, what's this?
We have the same resources.
What's this?
You're on it, that's why.
Your favorite guys now, the ones that are popular, the musicians, work for Camel's friend, Easy Freak,
yes.
They do whatever they do, ne?
Yeah.
They have the same resources as Drake.
Yeah.
But the thing, on the come up, they didn't come up the same time as Drake.
Yes.
So they put Drake.
Okay, so yes, Drake. And Drake's older than like a lot of the younger guys now. Okay.
Yeah, and Drake is the oldest.
Hold on. So I'm saying, if we compare, okay, now this is a different argument, so I'll get into this. But like, if we're comparing, he's like 30 something, dude.
Yeah, I'm saying he's the only guy from his, it's him and Chris Brown, from his, where they came out,
yes,
together within Abolilwe and them, who's still relevant nowadays.
Yes.
He's the oldest. Then the rest is the new generation. In this music industry, you're only relevant for 10 years. I'm not gonna lie to you.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
If I'm 16 and you popping,
yeah,
I'm gonna be 26 when you, that's the 10-year period. Yeah. When I'm 26, I won't listen to you again.
Yeah.
That generation is gone. People who were born
then. I can say someone like Drake makes it very hard for someone like talented and insane to get into the industry.
No, he does. He actually does.
He does.
If they're competing.
The thing is,
so in America, there's a lot of popular cats that are not international.
He's international. No, I won't take that away. I know that. That there are artists there that when we hear about them, we're like, what? But we look at guys like Drake. But someone like Drake, there'll be a guy who's very popular in America, like very popular, and people say you should be international. But someone like Drake will make it impossible for that guy, unless Drake himself
takes it,
goes and like, all right, let's collaborate.
Yeah. Another thing I want to say
about
Drake,
I'd say he's like a, I don't like saying he's a god.
Let me tell you here.
Popular
music. Let me tell you here.
Drake will decide if you're popular or not.
No, he won't. Let me
look
tell
at Block Boy JB.
Wait, let me tell you one thing. You see this music industry, the international artist.
Drake, you are in, bro.
The international artist, yeah. in the States, or the international artist, they play to get, they came.
I'm posting this today.
Wait, bro. They came up together. If you check what I mean. DJ Khaled, you Chris Brown, they all collaborate. Whatever the hit song they make, they're all together there. Whatever song they make, the like most of the songs, Drake, he is alone. Most of the popular songs is not alone. He's with the guys.
That's
18. Most popular songs of Drake.
Drake's popular songs by himself, bro.
God's Plan, himself.
God's Plan, himself. He didn't produce it himself. He's still with the same producers who came up with him. That's the thing. That's what I'm saying.
He
can't do it on his own.
Oh, bro, come on.
It's like Mfetu. What's this?
Summers put on my producer and my
tracks. Do you honestly think that Khaled produces his beats by himself? Masters his beats by himself.
Also, DJ Khaled is also big.
He's big.
Yeah.
No one is in them by themselves, bro. No one does anything by themselves.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying.
Even Marvin Gaye, bro. Like, you get someone like, okay,
they keep each other relevant.
You listen to this, what must I change?
Yes.
They keep each other relevant. That's what I'm saying. I'm not saying with you, like in the come up, whoever that's there, in the big Drakes, whatever, you Nicki Minaj's, you whatever. They keep each other relevant because they collaborate with each other. They know each other. That's why they make it hard for everybody else to come and replace the gang.
Someone like Party Next Door, brilliant writer.
Who?
Party Next Door.
Yeah, Party Next Door. I don't like them because they make some sense of music which is not.
If you like Drake songs, like Party Next Door because
Party Next Door writes Drake songs.
They write for Drake.
Yeah, he writes for Drake. Party Next Door.
Okay, okay.
But like, not all of them. Some of them.
No, some of them. Yeah. But like, listen here. Party Next Door knows. Wow, if he had to sing that song or whatever by himself, it won't go as hard. But give it to Drake.
Yeah, obviously, dog.
Drake, you give him something. He's like, alright, I can do it like this. Make it way bigger than it's meant to be.
Yeah.
Why?
Because Brian is there. It's not about talent. Now he's no longer that talented like back in the days. Drake is no longer that talented now. He's old, just trying to stay relevant. So that's why they feed him everything
Drake,
and he knows
Drake,
he's perfect.
Drake doesn't need to try to stay relevant.
Yeah, I'm saying he's trying to.
Drake,
if you can stop doing Drake, music, you're telling me what he.
Drake
won't
defines
be like
relevancy in my mind.
Wait. Drake, so you're telling me that if Drake decides to keep quiet and stop doing music, it's still going to be this popular?
100%.
Never, boy. Look, it's gonna be like Pete Davidson. He's gonna have a company and whatever, and sit down.
Dude.
If he comes on TV, you'll be like, oh, it's Drake. Dude. That's it. You won't forget his name or forget whatever. You'll be like, oh, that's Drake. But then next thing, after 2 seconds, they play Super Bowl. What a Super Bowl.
Listen, yeah.
You turn up to that, you're like, oh, Drake.
I can guarantee you, if Michael Jackson was still alive today, he could have gone silent for 2 years, just performing whatever.
Yeah.
He would drop a track.
Yeah.
He would blow up.
Yeah, I'm not saying that.
Drake can do the exact same thing.
I'm saying if he stops
what?
Doing music, he won't be that relevant anymore. He'll be there, he'll be popular, he'll be know everything, but then he'll be like, oh, it's Drake. That's it. There's nothing interesting
but
anymore.
If Drake had to pop back in.
Yeah, it depends. He's going to lose a lot of fans, though. Bro, he's going to lose a lot of fans. It's about habits, boy. It's about habits. It's about habits. If you create a habit and then you create a new habit, it's easy to you'll be like, oh, it's Drake. But now, because
like
you
Jay-Z.
Listen to a lot of Hill songs,
it's like Jay-Z.
You'll be like, oh, Drake.
What about Benny releases? But if Jay-Z had to release today, that thing will be the most spoken thing for the next 2 weeks. His project is
up. Actually, let me just say whatever. It's cool. PSSHOT signing out. Follow me on Instagram at Big Shot. Follow me at Big Shot.
I tagged you, bro. Don't worry. I'll put you in the bio. Don't worry. I'm posting this today, niggas.
Like Drake, he cannot make, like, let's say he doesn't make music for me. Obviously, we won't see it.
Yeah.
But let's hear the announcement Drake is dropping. Look, Kendrick Lamar, perfect example. TDE don't do releases year by year, they do 2 year breaks, 2 year minimum without releasing. But if Kendrick right now had to go tweet or put on Instagram that he's releasing tomorrow,
It's over, bro.
What do you think is going to happen to the internet?
It's a rap, bro.
He's literally going to destroy the internet. Like, what the hell? He's releasing tomorrow.
Bro, that's what
Drake is like that, but elevated. There's going to be white girls.
Bro, you know a lot about the music industry. You know it's not him alone.
No,
there's people behind the scenes who do most of the things.
Obviously, I didn't say it's Drake by himself.
Yeah, so I'm just saying.
But the guys behind the scenes are there behind the scenes for a reason.
Most of them, they're controlling. He's just the face of Drake.
But
Drake is a brand. Drake is a brand of not one person.
Yes, I agree.
But the thing is,
he's a face.
But I can tell you this. Ask any of those guys who work with him.
Yeah.
I can say this.
They use him. No, but they're saying. The face.
Yeah, but besides,
the brand, it's a successful brand.
Those guys will say, without him, we can't take any other person and be this big.
Yeah, they can't.
Why? Because there's something in him.
No, there's nothing in him. It's just that the face and the brand is popular.
Yeah, then why is there no one else like Drake? Like Drake, I mean. Like, I'm not saying there's no one else that's popular.
It's like you're comparing Nike with well, not Nike. What's the biggest, like, whatever label that you know that's popular.
Well, like Louis Vuitton or something.
Yeah, you are Louis Vuitton doesn't cater for everybody.
Like Off-White or something.
Like Off-White.
Yeah.
You even if you remove the design, even if you remove the design and then they still maintain the same thing, it's Off-White. It's everybody's still gonna go into that hype. I'm saying now the face. If they change Off-White from the normal looking feel they have and then they put. The phone, your Bad Boy Society, they leave it like that. They don't change next for days. You think people are still gonna jump after it if it doesn't drop? No. Now, the face. Drake is the face.
Oh, can I say something if you use an example like that?
Drake is the face.
You see what CR7?
CR7, Christian, yeah.
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 Take him away from it. Let's say Nike.
Yeah, it's gone.
Nah, let's say, Nike just released that. Think about, now it's
Drake is a brand on its own.
I understand.
You cannot say it's. Are we replacing Drake with Kendrick Lamar, but you're going to call him Drake?
Dude, listen, yeah.
There's a new Drake.
There's a reason why Drake is so big. Something about him.
No, there's nothing about him. It's just the name. They built it up. It's a company. They built up the name as the brand, Drake. And the face of it, the face of the thing is popular.
Linda.
If you become the face of something, my man, and then...
You'll have to agree with me, yeah. Mm. Like, let's say Nike and Adidas didn't use sports stars, famous sports stars. Do you think it would be this big?
Nah, they wouldn't.
Sports stars?
Yeah.
Nah, they wouldn't.
They wouldn't. It's the same thing. If Drake... you can't compare sports stars with Drake.
Listen,
Nike is not Cristiano Ronaldo. But Drake is... What's his name? What's his real name?
Aubrey.
Yeah, Drake is Aubrey.
But listen, as much as you say there's people behind him, I don't disagree.
Yeah, what I'm saying
is there's something about Aubrey himself.
No, there's nothing about Aubrey himself. You tell me if he changes the name from Drake to something else, he's still going to be this popular.
If you start off with something else.
If he changes the name.
The person we see today.
Yeah.
Whatever is driving him inside, whatever.
If he changes the name.
He'll still be popular.
If he changes the name from Drake to something else.
Obviously right now, that'd be stupid. But like,
you see, it's the brand. He's maintaining the brand. And he is. There's the difference between Shaba, the actor, and Shaba, the normal guy, and Thabang Mathonsi. There's a difference between Big Shot and Thabang Mathonsi. There's a difference between Drake and Aubrey. Drake is what? Is the brand, and he's the face of the brand. Now, Drake knows this world. The thing is with other artists who go up and then fall, the thing is that they end up being the brand, not being Dwayne Johnson or who's Lil Wayne? What's Lil Wayne's name?
Dwayne Carter.
Dwayne Carter. They become Lil Wayne. And then Lil Wayne's lifestyle compared to Dwayne, they're different. Because Lil Wayne, yes, this is a brand that makes money. He has to pay people. It's a money-making scheme. He also has to get paid from Lil Wayne. Dwayne has to get paid from Lil Wayne. Drake has to get paid from... what's his name? Aubrey has to get paid from Drake. You get what I'm saying? So now, other artists, they decide to become what? To become the Drake and forget their true identity. I'm working for Drake. I am the face of Drake. You feel me? So now, if he decides to leave Drake, everything else is going to be affected. Not only him. He's not saying these other people won't have jobs and whatever. Look at Maphorisa. He made one remix or he was a co-producer for one dance. Came to South Africa just because he worked with the company, Drake. You feel me? Anyways, let's just leave it there. Best SHOT.
I just wanna say this.
But Drake is useless. I hate Drake. I like trap soul. I love Kana. Lil Baby. Lil Baby's coming to South Africa.
Alright.
Lil Baby's coming to South Africa for the first time. Guys, get your tickets.
I just want to say this. I'm not, by no means am I a Drake stan. I like Drake, but I'm not a stan. This has been a great episode. The Art Dealers is back, guys. It's been a while. Jobs is here. Jobs say something to the people before we end.
We just, hey, Baba.
Alright, guys, we're closing off. Josh, producer, will you sign off with Art Dealers? Peace out.
This is the Art Dealers.
I just want to say that as a special guest, I had an amazing time on our dealers.
First of many, guys.
It's the first time I've, you know, cracked the invite, and it's because all the other art dealers weren't available.
But it's I do want to say this. I do want to say sorry to Jason Sandals for not being here, because he's been asking to be on, but you just weren't here. Sorry.
I don't think Jason knows anything about music. I don't think he could add.
Art dealers signing.
Cheers out.